Hello, I'm Chris Menard. I have a great Excel video for you today. If you are an MBA student, because I train professional MBAs, I train executive MBAs, and also train CPAs in Excel, this would be a great video. If you're just a business person, you should know how to do this video. It is a weighted moving average. A few weeks ago, I did a simple moving average. I'll put the link to that video down below. But I'm also going to do one in this video to compare it to the weighted moving average. So let's go ahead and dive in. In case you're wondering what in the world is a weighted moving average, let's say that I want to average 6 months of data. And then when the new month comes, the 6 months changes to the previous 6 months. So as an example, let's say it's August 2023 and we just closed out the month and I'm tracking orders. It could be orders, it could be revenue, it could be temperature. Well, August of 2023, if I'm looking 6 months back, that would be March of 2023. August should have more weight than March of 2023 because it's older. And then it'll go April to September, and September is going to get the most weight compared to April. The inspiration for this video came. I use Vanguard. I use Fidelity. I'm not recommending them. I'm just telling you what I do. And I was reading along, and I saw this article on Fidelity. I'll put a link to this down below also about a weighted moving average. So here we go. I've got a list of weather dates. Let's say we're headed from spring to summer, so it's gradually getting warmer. I want to do 5 days. Up in cell C1, I have SMA, that means simple moving average. So this is the video I did a few weeks ago. So I'm going to take the average of those 5 cells, 51.2. By the way, just to check it, if I highlight them, it says 51.2 down at the bottom. Crosshairs, double click, just to show you this. Cell C7 is the average of B3 to B7. The next cell down is B4 through B8. So there's the simple moving average. Now to do the weighted moving average, you've got to figure out, one, how many months, and we've already decided 5 months, but it could be 3 months, 4 months, 5, 6, 7. It is up to you what number you want to look at. To keep this simple, I put these percentages over here. Notice they do total 1. So the most recent day 5, is going to carry the most weight for this first example. I'm going to do this the long way, and then I'll show you a cool trick I know. So I'm going to take the 53, I'm going to do this quickly, times 0.4 plus B5 times 0.3 plus B4 times 0.15 plus B3 times 0.1 plus B2 times 0.05. 52.5 is the weighted moving average. If I pull that down one time, I'm going to check the formula. Perfect. Everything's working. Crosshairs, double click. So column C's got the simple, column D has got the weighted. In case you're wondering, what is the average? I think I just did 30 days. What's the average of these 30 days? I'm on the home tab, I'm in the editing group, average, B2 to B32. It's okay that it's got a blank. So the average is 62.3. There we go. And then here's our weighted. I'm going to just do some quick formatting. It's going to drive me crazy if I don't. There we go. The weighted moving average, it looks very similar to the simple, but if your numbers start getting a lot of difference in them, the weighted is probably a better reflection of what's going on. Now, here's my tip for you. I'm not really happy with what I did in cell D6 and autofill down, and the reason is, what if I want to tweak the percentages? What if I want to give more weight to the more current day? Well, it's really hard here because I got to go and tweak all of this and make sure it adds up to the number 1. So I'm going to simply copy this. I'm going to put it in I. Let's give it a header row. Wait. Let's make it official. Wait. Paste it. Copy, paste. And then I'm going to do a sort smallest to largest. Perfect. And then just to test it, I just want to make sure it still adds up to one, and it does. Forget about column G for right now. Act like column G is not here. I only care about column I. I'm going to call it weighted moving average 2. This is how I would do this. Equals the sum. I'm doing 5 days. So B2 through B6 times. I'm highlighting my weights. Close parenth. What is going to happen here is it's going to take B2 and multiply it times cell I2. And it's going to take B3 and multiply it times I3, B4 times I4. I do need to keep these constant, so I'm making them absolute reference. So the F4 function key, $i, $2, $i, $6. If you need to type them manually, do it. Let's see, I should get 52.5. Control enter, 52.5, 52.5. Pull it down one time. Yep, because we're doing some rounding. I just want to test this real quick. 53.65, 53.65. Perfect. Crosshairs, double click. Same exact numbers, but now I'm just making this up. I can say, okay, I want day 5, the most recent day, to be 0.5. 0.35, I'm making up these numbers, 0.2, 0.15, 0.06, I know I'm off, it's okay. You see where I'm headed though. 2.0. There we go. So now I can quickly tweak the weighted moving average and give more weight to the more recent day, which changes your numbers. One last one, I'm going to just leave this with you, but here I'm just going to, this file that I'm in, I'm going to make available on my website to download. You don't have to subscribe to anything, just go click it and download it. But I'll put on my blog post, I'll put some more detail about the weighted moving average and give some other examples of when you would use it. But here I'm using revenue on this one here. And here's my weights over here, and I've already done some formulas here. Hope you enjoyed this video. Feel free to subscribe, ring the bell. If you have any questions about a simple moving average versus a weighted moving average, please let me know. Have a wonderful day. Thank you.